Today we are going to learn about MATLAB's symbolic toolbox. We are going to discuss why and how to use symbolic toolbox, how to solve nonlinear and multivariable equations, how to plot symbolic expressions, and how to integrate and differentiate mathematical expressions. Basically, when we want to define a variable in MATLAB, we must assign a value to it. But there is an alternative option in which the variable contains no value, a symbolic variable. I type sims x. I defined a few more variables. You can see I have 4 variables and all of them belong to symbolic type. From basic algebra, we know that x plus x is 2x, or a times a is a squared. That's exactly how MATLAB performs mathematical operations on symbolic variables. A squared plus 4 times a squared is 5 times a squared. I defined my first expression, cosine of x squared plus sine of x squared. You probably know that this expression is equal to 1. To display the expressions in their simple form, use simplify command. Another example. Now I have this expression. If I execute simplify function on it, MATLAB displays the expression with no change. It means it doesn't get simpler than that. To see the expanded form of the expression, use expand function. It is important to find the numerical value of a symbolic expression. I define this expression and I want to know its value if x is equal to 3. I type subs, which stands for substitute, expression 2, 3. It puts 3 in place of x. Now if I have multiple symbolic variables like this and I run subs, expression 3, 3, again, it puts 3 instead of x, and a and b are left unchanged. This is how MATLAB works. It gives priority to some variables. If you want the value of a equal to 3, you should mention it specifically, with or without single quotes. Or if you want to give values for a and b, put them in curly brackets. Here, a equals to 3 and b equals to 5. I define this expression and substitute 10 for its variable x. It gave me the answer, but it doesn't seem like a number, so you have to convert it to one. Use double function. Now you have the answer with 4 decimal digit precision. If you look closely, you can see an indent here. That's the difference in displaying numeric or symbolic values. Symbolic numbers or expressions have no indent, but numeric numbers do. You can specify your desired precision with this command, VPA. So I type VPA subs f, 10, and I set the precision to 3, or 15, or 30. Now it's time to solve equations. Just use solve and type your expression. Don't confuse equality symbol with assignment symbol. I have my answer, and since there is no indent, I know that they are symbolic numbers. I can check that too. I convert the answers to double format. If I type an equation without its right-hand side, MATLAB considers the right-hand side to be 0. You can see, same answers. If my expression has multiple symbolic variables, MATLAB solves it for x. Again, it gives priority to x. If you want to solve it for another variable, specify it like this. If I have 3 equations for 3 variables, MATLAB solves all equations simultaneously and returns the answers in a structure. This structure has 3 fields, one for each variable. If you don't like to work with the structures, save the results in 3 variables. Now each variable contains its solution for the equation. Again, remember that these are symbolic numbers. You may want to convert them to double type numbers. Differentiating and integrating are done via these commands, diff and int. Let's differentiate tangent of x, or y squared times cosine of 3x. You can see that differentiation is performed with respect to x. If you want to change it, specify the variable. Here I differentiate with respect to y. Indefinite integration of sine of x. The answer is minus cosine of x. One more example. You can also perform definite integration. I set the integration interval to 0, 4. You can easily plot symbolic expressions. I plot this expression with EasyPlot and FPlot. I can specify the horizontal axis too. One last command. If your expression is long and difficult to read, use PRETTY function. It displays it in the pretty way, making it easier to read and comprehend. And that's it, we come to the end of our tutorial. We will discuss other features of symbolic toolbox in the future tutorials. So please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.